Unfortunately, I didn't have enough time to play with this as much as I'd like, but I'd like to point out a couple of things that aren't in any of the URSA Mini 4K or 4.6K videos that you see online, and isn't in the manual either, so I'm going to go through them very, very quickly. First off, you'll see that we have a B4 mount adapter on this 4.6K PL and a Fujinon high definition lens, and this is one of their better lenses. It's a digiservo lens, it's a XA lens. So first thing that hasn't been pointed out before, in the manual it doesn't say that XA lenses are compatible. They are. I've tested it. Both the zoom function from your ATEM and the iris function from your ATEM or from the SDI Arduino shield work, and they work beautifully with this lens. This is the lens that I believe was originally paired with the Panasonic HPX 500 series of cameras. Good piece of glass, 2/3 inch B4 mount lens. All right, that's the first thing you're not going to find. The second thing is that when putting together the this is a PL mount originally. All right, PL mount lens. Here we have now PL from RE, positive lock for your professional video cameras. All right, when you're taking this off, well, not when you're taking this off, it's not that important. When you're putting it back on, it is. But when you're putting on the B4 mount, you need a torque wrench. Do not mix that up with a Torx, T-O-R-X wrench. Torx wrench, T-O-R-X, and torque, T-O-R-Q-U-E wrench are two different things, right? In the comments, or not in the comments, but in the notes section below, you'll see a link to an Amazon link for a torque wrench, and you want one that's 0.45 newtons. What you'll see online are in centinewtons, so you'll see instead of 0.45, since it's multiplied by 100, a centi-100 newton, right, named after, of course, the turn of the, I guess, the last century's physicist. It'll be in different units, so centinewtons, so it'll be 45 as opposed to 0.45, right? Don't let that throw you off. The link below is correct. You need that, number one. Number two, when you get the B4 mount, and it's in the other video I have that hopefully YouTube links to that, it comes in this package with a nice protective cover in the back, right, and a lens cover at front. Note that, you see these screw holes, that the mount is actually screwed into this. It looks like you just twist it off, and the screws are black, just like the aluminum, or I guess it's aluminum and not graphite, or like the rest of the camera, but there are screws in it, so you can't screw it off. You have to find it. They are 2 millimeters hex, so 2 millimeter hexagonal screws. That is in the manual, but what they don't tell you is that this thing is actually screwed in when you get it. And they kind of go over it, that there's a bunch of shims. Two come with the camera, or one is in the camera, two come with the mount. You need to use all three for the B4 mount. All right, so again, before you do anything, because you don't want to break off a screw or over tighten it or under tighten it, is make sure you get that torque, not Torx, torque wrench to put this thing on. Right, no, it looks expensive, but it's worth it. It's an expensive camera. Affordable mount, but expensive camera. You don't want to have to drill out any screws or anything like that. Get the proper tool for the job. The last thing I want to say is that this is a magnificent camera. It's light, it's versatile. You can configure it in many ways. You see, I have a Zacuto mount on there. You could use it with Sony lenses, use it with Arri lenses, primes. It's great. The EF version is also very good. The 4K version, well, you've seen the reviews for that, but the 4.6 versus the Mini 4.6 PL, worth every penny.